Oh, he's videotaping.
All right, well, my name's Eric. I decided to use the pick rather than microblaze because I figured more people use picks. There's more picks out there than humans right now. That's what we use. There's like, they made their 7 billion years ago. So, why did I choose? That's why I chose the new pick.
Sure.
So, system requirements. Basically, I try to just redo the alarm clock lab. Using just the pick, so make a clock interface to the LCD and make the alarm go off when you set the alarm, user sets the alarm, and the alarm goes off. And I guess actual specifications, use the PIC24, use the PMOD LCD that we've all used already. The clock ticks based on hardware timer interrupts. Based on 1 second, and the output. So when the alarm goes off, the alarm will be driven by another hardware timer. That outputs a 500 hertz square wave. I chose 500 hertz just because it sounds different from 1,000, less annoying. And all the peripherals would just be interfaced with normal GPIO, so no SPI, nothing really fancy, which is good because nothing worked anyways. So, and there will be 4 buttons for the user to set the time, set the alarm. And so, how things actually turned out. So, we have the normal, alright, so there is microblaze here. I couldn't actually manage to get the PIC to respond to, or the LCD to respond to the PIC. I'm not sure why exactly that happened. I think it has some weird timing issues. So it also didn't help that the development board, the documentation for the development board was pretty incomplete. It claimed to have way more IOs than it actually worked. They had weird things like 2 IOs shorted together with 0 resistors that were impossible to take off. Really bizarre stuff like that. So we have microblaze. I have the PIC out here. What I actually use the PIC, I use the PIC to actually calculate the time or set the time, and I use the Nexus for, or I use microblaze as a $110 LCD controller. So GPIO, one GPIO for data because I passed in the data, or I passed in characters rather. Line to tell microblaze what digit on the clock I was sending, and obviously more GPIOs to talk to the LCD. Alright, so I guess I just kind of talked about the design, but so the PIC generates the clock, microblaze handles LCD. I use global variables just because it's more convenient. And timer to interrupt. How the interface with the GPI or with microblaze works is that the data line's 8 bits, and so that's constantly showing whatever byte, and then the control lines, since there's my control line was three bits, so I have eight options for that, but I only needed 6 numbers, so I have 2 extra. There are 6 because there's 6 digits in the clock. So basically the control line, I think I set like decimal 6 would indicate that control line showed decimal 6, then the data line, or that would indicate that the data line is shooting the character for like the 10th digit of the hours or something. And microblaze would refresh the display every 2 milliseconds. So what actually turned out to be a problem with my terrible interface was that since I didn't have enough GPIOs I was supposed to have access to 14 according to the data sheet of the development board, but it turned out that I maxed out at 11, which was exactly how many was needed to interface from the PIC to the Nexus board with the data lines and the control lines. So I didn't actually have any lines left for user input or alarm, which was kind of annoying. But, and the other problem was that since I didn't have a, or what I noticed was with a parallel interface, it's usually helpful for the reading device to kind of send up a flag. For the reading device to send up a flag saying I've read the data now, show me more, show me a different bit or byte. And I didn't do that, which is why I set the microprocessor to refresh to 2 milliseconds, because if it refreshed too slowly, the display would actually glitch over to another digit. I guess you can go see that. Print status. So what works? PIC does time. I know that for a fact. That works really well. Microglaze displays the LCD. Microglaze works really well at showing stuff on the display. What doesn't work? Development boards lie. I wasn't too happy that I couldn't actually get all the GPIOs that I wanted. Actually, not even close to all the ones I wanted. And what else doesn't work? Alarm the user, lack of I/O, same thing. Display is very glitchy due to poor parallel I/O implementation. Just like the same thing where I said previously. And this probably has to do with why I couldn't get an actual LCD to work with a PIC24 itself. Some pins behave really strangely. There are there are three GPIOs that actually didn't work, period. No matter what I wrote to their output registers, they wouldn't do anything. And there are, I think, two other pins that would have a logic low of 0 volts and a logic high of 800 millivolts, which is pretty worthless in standard CMOS. Other questions? The other thing was I tried, there was some weird muxing going on, but I made it really explicit that I didn't want them to do anything special. Like right out of the box, they should just behave like normal, I/O pins. And I tried explicitly saying, don't do anything special to these pins, just be normal. And even that didn't. So I want to blame the dev board because that seems to be really easy. But all I know is that the next time I use a PIC, I'm not going to use the dev board. Is your